dogs can make a massive difference in people's lives. No matter how bad your day is, you're going to have a good day if you have a dog. They've made my life whole.
If everyone had hearts same as dogs, this world would be a better place.
Someone who's struggling in their life, to add a dog is huge. It's endless love. Dogs add that extra happiness into people's lives.
On Sydney's Western Fringe is a picturesque doggy sanctuary.
Welcome to the Animal Welfare League. My name's Jade. It's so nice to meet the both of you.
Where people come in search of a soulmate.
I'm here to get a dog.
You're in the right place.
We found you a little chihuahua mix.
Oh, yeah, okay.
She is a beautiful kelpie.
Wow.
It's the best feeling, finding the perfect person for the dog. They're not broken, they don't need fixing, they just need love.
It's a boy!
Here, dedicated animal champions rescue the orphaned and abandoned.
It's not a high-paying job, it's not something that you do to build a mansion, it's something you do because you're passionate.
And work tirelessly towards making the perfect love match.
Oh, nervous!
Oh, soulmate.
Oh my gosh.
It's like a dating agency. We make the match and then we send them off on their very first date.
Gorgeous.
Definitely a swipe right.
Sometimes it's a miss.
Yay! Oh. Oh my god. Aren't you playing hard to get?
Not in love.
No, I don't like grunting.
Ernie!
I'm coming!
Uh-oh, off lead, guys.
But when Cupid's arrow strikes...
Oh, look at him.
It flies straight to the heart.
Oh, hey. Are we gonna love?
To know that they're going to a warm, cuddly home and have a family to sleep with tonight, that is the ultimate for us.
You alright, Nick?
Yeah. I've just been waiting for this day for a while.
Watching someone fall in love with a dog that you believe could be somebody's dream dog, that moment is magic.
I hope that everyone can feel this emotion, that they can experience how beautiful dogs can be and how much they can change your life.
It's an early start at the Animal Welfare League.
Good job.
Let's go, Daddy.
With space for up to 100 dogs on site, a revolving door ensures there's always room for more rescues.
You're right, love? It's a rock. Don't eat the rock! Don't eat the rock! Don't eat the rock! You're a rat bag!
5 dogs have just arrived after their owner sadly passed away.
She'll do it. Just a bit scared. When owners do pass away, the dogs do come to us and they are grieving, you know, they're really confused why they're here. You know, they don't eat, they don't really go to the toilet, they're really shut down, and that's a really hard thing to see.
So they did come from inspectors.
Yep.
Unfortunately, the owner passed away. We got Martin with 3 siblings and a mum as well, think. Martin's quite timid.
Mm.
Had a bit of concern there, so we'll do a lot of training. Hopefully we can find a really good home for Martin.
Dogs end up at the shelter for all sorts of reasons.
The neighbours moved out last week and the dog is still here, tied up in the yard.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that.
I actually get teased for never saying no. I always want to about all the animals who come in. Someone asks about an animal coming in, I just say yes, bring in, so then we can help it.
Sam has a real problem with the word no. He's a huge softie. We've even had turtles he found on the side of the road. He just says, we'll work it out, chaps. And off he goes about his business, and we've got to work it out.
17 dogs and puppies all up.
Oh, wow.
Which is quite a lot. So,
yeah. 17.
17, yeah.
Don't know how we'll go fitting 17 on there.
Can't say no to anything, so we'll have to make space.
One of the AWL staff is on the way in with a lively little pug.
This is Lily, a very energetic pug
it was initially lodged as a cruelty complaint.
She's a little ball of energy though, isn't she? She's jimmies around all over the place.
Nick to Brianna, we've just got our new surrender up here. If you're available to come up and bring it to the road, please.
Copy that.
I think we're going to find you a home.
I think we're going to find you a home. Yes, I do. Oh, is that good?
Is it? No, not the radio. Lily!
Snakes!
Where?
I'm Brian, and this is my family.
Is that it?
The Kwongs are hoping a canine companion will even out the family.
Yeah,
fine.
Yeah, true. You just take it personally sometimes.
Yeah, okay.
I'm a bit sensitive. Just need another male in the family.
Hello, everyone.
We've come to adopt a dog.
Yeah?
Yeah.
This is our first dog. Ever.
Ever.
As a family.
First pet.
Ever.
Yeah.
First pet?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Wow. That's it.
I think everyone like kind of has their own different reason for why they want a dog. So like Dad wants someone like to be more active with, and I just want some company. Giselle has, I don't know, like a bit of a fear that she wants to get over.
Good morning.
Oh, hi. Hey.
Good morning.
Hello.
I'm Nick. This is Jules.
Nick and Jules.
Hi. What can we do for you guys?
First dog for our family.
I think my only real request was to be a male dog.
Someone you can share the manly duties
with.
Yeah, exactly.
House with. Yeah, watch footy with.
Yeah.
I don't think we want a huge dog.
Well,
what are we thinking about?
Giselle is a little bit scared of dogs.
A little bit.
Okay.
I'm scared of a lot of things.
Yeah.
Like, I'm scared of, like, the dark. I'm scared of... Oh, I'm just outing myself here. See, usually they just make fun of me.
Did something happen?
Yeah, I was bit by my cousin's dog.
Okay.
What sort of dog was it?
It's a Maltese Shih Tzu.
Alrighty, well, we are gonna go back, see what we can put together.
See you soon.
Okay.
We'll just let her...
Suck it up.
Yeah. We'll just push they aren't gonna do much. They're just gonna be like, deal with it. Like, it's not gonna bite you or anything.
This will be their first pet.
Okay. No rabbits, no geeks.
Yeah, how exciting. We get a lot of first-time owners who come through our doors, and what we tend to do is try and match them up with a dog who has a lot less needs and behavioural issues.
Giselle is a bit fearful of dogs. She doesn't want anything that's too hyper that'll be jumping on her and jumping in her face.
Dad does want something to, you know, sit on the lounge, have a beer with, watch footy.
Is that what he said?
Yeah.
What about that little dog that came with Oreo?
Everything he's... is the best thing he's ever seen, and he loves to investigate life, and he's very excitable when he sees other dogs.
Yeah, I think he's gonna be too excitable.
Yeah. What about adorable little Jimmy?
So cute. Look at his little face.
I know, he's adorable. He's a really confident dog. He's easygoing. He's also a boy, which is not the dad.
Jimmy!
He likes to be patted, and he loves his treats. He's really...
He's probably a good size too.
Jimmy then?
Jimmy it is, Jimmy. I think.
So it was quite challenging search. Being first time dog owners, we do think we have come up with one dog.
Yep.
Fun news. Good news.
His name is Jimmy.
Mm-hmm. It's a boy, Brian.
It's a boy.
Congratulations.
How are you guys feeling?
I'm just anxious.
You're anxious.
Yeah.
Nervous.
Okay,
that's okay. He is a people lover. So would you guys like to meet him?
Yeah.
Ready?
Okay.
All right, perfect.
Let's do it.
Excellent, let's do it.
Jimmy, hi. What's that?
Oh, good boy. Oh, good boy. Oh, yes.
We don't know much about Jimmy's history.
Let's go, yes.
However, we did rescue him from a regional pound. Jimmy's personality is very cheeky. He loves to instigate a good play.
Oh, you're so backflip.
I think Jimmy has lots of love to give. He's come out of his shell so much and he loves all the staff here. So I think he'd fit really easily into a family that would love to give him lots of cuddles.
Who's going to talk?
You can.
Here we go.
So cute.
It's cozy.
Bench.
darling.
I'll sit over here.
How are you feeling? Nervous? I think Gigi's a little bit scared, so we'll see. We'll just let the dog sniff us and come to us first.
I was terrified of stick insects.
Yeah.
Terrified. Shut up, Sam. I was. It was a real fear.
What if it jumps on us? You just let it jump. You just don't. It's going to be tight. We're going to adopt you.
Whenever I see a dog, everyone else around me really likes them. Like, it's really like, oh my God, so cute. But I'm just scared of them. Like, inside I'm like, oh my God, is he going to bite me? Is he going to jump on me?
Good job, Jimmy. Let's go.
Good boy.
Now, I think we're ready to get a dog.
You ready?
So, fingers crossed that the connection's there and Giselle can overcome her fear of dogs.
Oh, yes, I can see. I can see.
Hoping spunky little Jimmy doesn't scare their youngest daughter, Giselle.
Oh, beautiful!
That's the dog in my dream. What's the dog in my dream?
Oh, he's gorgeous.
This is Jimmy.
Hello.
Hi, Jimmy.
My heart does beat fast. I freeze, and then it just ends up going to another person.
So if you're happy, I might lead you guys to it.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, no worries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's okay.
Oh, my God. Oh, no.
Oh, Jimmy, ready? Oh,
down
there.
Cute. Jimmy.
I don't want
to... Maybe he's still on the steps.
Oh, there he is. Look at him.
Oh, look at him. He's adorable.
Look what I've got. Yeah, you love it. Yeah, I heard you love food.
Yes. When people get dogs for the first time, do you see a lot of this behaviour that Dad's doing here where he's whipping his hand away with the treat because he's worried the dog's going to actually bite? Now, it's almost teasing,
it's teasing with the treat.
You better put it on your flat hand.
Yeah.
That way, even if the dog is a bit, you know, grabby, there's nothing to grab.
Hey, do you mind going back into the yard and just showing him how to give a treat to a dog?
I'd really like Giselle to give him a treat. I'd really, really like to see that.
I don't have any more. Oh, kiss me on the nose.
Giselle, she's not willing to actually sit down yet. She's ready to get up and move if something happens.
Jimmy.
If Giselle's afraid of the dog, then maybe that's not the right dog for our family, actually, because at the end of the day, you know, we're a family unit and we have to feel comfortable.
Ooh. How's he going in here?
He just loves the food.
One more? That's it.
I've got one.
Oh, look.
You can just hold it even on the end. He just will take it from your hand. It's very gentle. See, if we give him the treat when he does nothing, he's just going to expect food all the time.
It is something that you do take for granted. That we grew up speaking dog language from the time we were very little.
Yeah.
If you've not been around them, it's a whole new language that you have to learn.
Yeah.
If you're willing to do all the training.
Yeah, I'm more than happy to do all the training.
Johnny and Eva want to find their son a four-legged friend.
We have a 13-year-old son. His name's Jude, and he's dog crazy.
So what are we looking for today?
It's actually a surprise for our 13-year-old son. He's been honoured us to have a dog for a really long time.
We love surprising him. Does Jude like being surprised by us?
I don't know.
Yeah, probably not as much.
We'll keep going.
Exactly. We're very forceful.
So who's going to make the final decision,
hey? Me. Sorry, Johnny.
He's learning, his brain's starting to be like, oh.
That's what it is.
If I do work, I'll get my treats.
This is what they need, is somebody in there to actually guide them through the process.
Suck her up. You see that? A little pat from Giselle?
I saw that.
Giselle, do you want to maybe try giving him a treat? Otherwise, get a big one if you're not comfortable with a really small one.
I'll just get a flat one to get off your hand.
Yeah.
God, this would be a big step for Giselle.
I don't know that she's ready for it. She doesn't look comfortable.
So you letting him smell you is you're introducing yourself to him.
Yeah. Just like by offering.
Yes, okay. Yeah,
Jimmy. Just let him smell you.
Just Jimmy.
He just goes, sit, and sip it and sit.
I like that a lot.
That's because you've got the jar.
Jimmy, hold that.
Giselle's got food. Yeah, so put your hand out and call his name.
Jimmy.
Call him.
Jimmy,
call him.
Jimmy.
Just call him.
Come on.
Just say sit.
Sit, sit.
Go to sit,
sit, sit.
Closer.
Sit.
Yeah, sit.
Good boy.
Good boy.
Hi.
A nice, that real smile on her face. It's beautiful.
You want a little massage?
Oh, he's like, yeah.
Nice, isn't it?
Aww.
Do you like tummy rubs?
Oh, you do.
Oh, he's such a good dog, Jimmy. He's actually a really good dog for a first-time family.
Yeah, exactly.
He's literally going to every single person and like, rub my belly.
It's nice to see him bonding.
Oh, yeah.
Good boy.
That feels good, doesn't it?
Yourself.
Do you guys want to go for a walk?
I think that might be a good idea.
Yeah,
let's do that.
Giselle was a little bit scared, a little bit nervous, and I felt quite concerned for her about that. But time will tell, I think.
Good girl.
We want to surprise our about to turn 14-year-old son with the dog.
That's awesome. Do you guys know what sort of dog he would want?
He would take any dog.
Yeah?
So I think the question is more, what dog
would... We looked at each other and like,
What dog would Eva want?
I'm sensing there's a little bit of a difference of opinion here.
We live in the inner city.
Okay.
We live
in a small apartment.
With a small balcony.
So no Great Danes.
Exactly.
Johnny, if you close your eyes
and
you pictured your dream dog, what does that look like?
Oh, God, here we go. I love the idea, super smart, something that I can train and, you know, have as a real companion. I would love a dog like that.
And Eva, can I ask you the same question?
My dream dog is a teacup Yorkie. They're so cute, they're so small, you can take it anywhere. The poops would be this big. Just be easy to look after, maintain.
It's more of an accessory than
you
a
could
dog.
Just, like a little puff.
They do seem to be very much... not on the same page with the kind of dog they want.
No.
But they're willing to compromise.
Okay, cool.
They would be quite easy to match with a few. I have a particular soft spot in my heart for the willy pug, little Lily. You know, pugs in apartments, fantastic. Not going to be left out in the backyard panting away.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Great size. It'd be very suitable for her.
An easy dog for Jude to look after himself. For a second option.
Schnitzel is not a bad idea. Having a working dog in an apartment is possible. It's just about the amount of work that you've got to put in.
Yeah.
I mean, she's an absolute darling of a dog.
I think all they should do is meet both, and then they're giving a decision of having a small dog to a medium-sized dog, one more active, one a bit less active, and then go from there.
Hello.
Hello.
So just like you guys, we've had a little bit of a discussion and we've come up with two very different options.
Okay. Yeah.
We would really like you to meet both of the options.
To keep your thoughts open.
Yeah, no, I'm happy to meet two.
Schnitzel.
Oh my God, I love that name too.
My only concern is she is maybe a little too active for you. She is a Kelpie cross.
Lily is a very cheeky girl, but very confident.
Yeah.
She's a bit smaller than Schnitzel. She is a pug.
Okay.
I like that you've got one for both of us.
Yeah.
I mean, ultimately, this is Jude's dog. Our son, Jude, would be happy with any dog, honestly.
Yeah. I can't wait to see his face.
Yeah.
Hi, Schnitzel.
So she is a Kelpie cross who came in with her brothers and sisters from a cruelty case from our inspectorate.
All right, let's go. Good job.
She has had a pretty rough start to life.
She's still learning to build bonds with people, but she's doing a really cracker job. She does love to climb in our laps and have a good cuddle. Kelpies are incredibly active dogs. They were originally working dogs, so we need to make sure that we're keeping up with their energy levels as well as mentally stimulating them as well. Schnitzel would suit quite an active family that are happy to take her on.
Oh my God, how cute.
Oh gosh, this is awesome.
No.
The day that our son Jude was born was the best day. It is as clear as it was yesterday for me. The minute you have a child, it's your heart walking outside of your body. There's no protective device around it. And that night I'll never forget, because the nurses left us in the room and we had this brand new baby, and we just both looked at each other and said, what do we do now? No manual.
You leave the house with the two of you and then you come back and there's all of a sudden three, and then that's forever. There's pre-Jude and post-Jude within our lives, and yeah, the post is definitely better.
So much better. What?
I'm just thinking, like, it must be so weird for the dog right now going into meet two strangers.
They're going,
they're
getting now. Good. Now what do you want?
Now what are you looking for in an owner? We're a very, very close-knit family. We all like hanging out with each other, and
although as a teenager, that's sort of, you know.
Hence one of the reasons we're here to get a dog, is to drag that little bit back, a bit closer.
In a few years' time, when he might be going to university or moving out of home, we'll say, where did that time go? Remember when he was just 13? So you've got to hold on to every little minute.
And get
a dog,
right.
Because when he leaves, we'll have the dog.
That's right.
Let's go.
Oh, here it comes.
Good. Come on.
Oh my God.
Here we have Schnitzel.
Hi, Schnitzel.
Hey.
So she is our two-year-old Kelpie mix.
Yeah.
If you guys are comfy, I'll let her off just so that she can have a bit of a sniff. Good girl, Schnitzel. Free to get up, move around,
yeah,
have
you know,
throw some toys.
She does
love a tennis ball.
She's so gorgeous.
Oh. Hi there.
Enjoy.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you. See you later.
She's the active dog that Johnny wanted. Whether it's the right dog for the whole family.
Where's the ball?
Here. Come on. Get the ball. Come here. Good girl.
Oh, best in show.
Good girl.
So smart, but not interested in that ball.
Come on, come here.
Good girl.
Sit.
Good girl.
There you go, you've trained it already.
Good girl, good girl.
Eva's standing back. I think she's just observing the situation. She wants to see how this dog would fit into their family, and maybe she's just a little hesitant.
That she'll compromise for Johnny's happiness would be the question here.
Good girl. Good girl. You want to go again or you want to have a sit?
Come on, up here.
Good girl.
Sit.
Good girl. Good girl.
Like, this is your dream scenario right now. I've never seen you so happy. You're this happy on her wedding
night. I just love her. You're so gorgeous.
Wow.
He's fallen
in love.
That's
a real connection.
The good thing is she can go for a run. But then she'll chill.
I mean, hold on.
She's only small.
Keep your options.
Don't be like that with her.
Lily.
Yeah, I
don't know. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hi.
Come on.
Hi, so how have you guys been going with Schnitzel?
Fantastic. Good. Schnitzel,
she's
come
gorgeous.
Here.
It's just the activity level, like she is.
Yeah.
Is it full on? Like, what is it? Because we live in an apartment.
No, that's okay. So the way that we combat that is, as well as doing physical exercise, we also try to get their brain stimulated as well.
Yeah, yeah. I've been dreaming of a dog named Schnitzel that I can call out to at the dog park. We just couldn't take it for dinner.
Schnitzel anyone?
Schnitzel anyone? Yeah.
To me, that dog needs space. You're all here. I'm all here. She's captured your heart.
She has captured my heart.
Well, it's not a decision yet. It's not Lily is coming in. You need to just Schnitzel who?
Yep.
meets their potential owner, they do get their hopes up.
Kill, I know.
And it can be really hard when things don't work out. First impressions really count, so we do everything we can to get them looking, feeling, and smelling their best for the occasion.
Let's go!
This here is Lily. She's a 3.5-year-old pug cross. She's incredibly sweet and full of beans. Lily would suit an active home that want a really snuggly companion that can go places with them and is going to be really included in the family.
Let's go! Bye!
For the right family, I think Lily would be an absolutely hilarious companion. You can see her coming from a mile away because she's got such a sassy little trot.
It's not a decision. This pug will come in and just fly.
Can I?
Oi. Oh.
Adored King Charles Cavalier Sophie needs a furry friend, so her family will stop competing for her attention.
Weekend plans, hang out with my dog. The best shirt ever.
And the best weekend plans.
Yeah.
My name's Dave.
Asri. We have 3 chickens and a dog.
Sophie?
Yes.
Sophie. Oh, Sophie! Hello! How are you?
Can I pat?
Yes.
Lovely. Just help myself.
So that's why we're here today?
Yes.
To find a new friend for Sophie and the family?
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
Getting another dog will reduce a lot of stress in our household, as the kids will have a dog each to sleep with.
Because we fight over her at bedtime and, yeah, causes them to stress.
So we're looking for a nice cuddle buddy for
me.
All right, beautiful.
She was born with attitude, Asri.
When she was 4, she walked into a chemist, informed me that she was having her ears pierced that day. Which she did.
Where do you think Sophie will sleep tonight?
With me, like usual. Sophie's favourite is me, because I mostly spend the most time with her.
Oh, you're so sad, Lucky.
I think getting another dog will fulfil Asri's life. Because of just the way that Sophie was able to bond with Zara. She feels a little bit ripped off.
Good. Come on.
Johnny and Eva are about to meet their second dog of the day, Lily Pug.
Oh.
Hello.
Hello.
We're back. A little bit of change of pace.
Oh, total change of pace.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh my God, here we have Lily.
Sit down.
Hello, Lily.
Oh, listen to that sound. Oh my God, she's like a little piggy pig.
Yeah. So incredibly food driven,
yes.
This one.
Yeah. Okay, this is all I've got left.
I'll let you guys mingle and okay,
yeah,
thank
yeah.
you.
Boing, boing, boing.
She wants to get up so badly. Her poor little legs.
Go on. See, she can fetch.
I didn't say she couldn't.
She
Where
can't
is
bring
it?
She can't bring it back.
Where is it?
Either dog is going to be a nice surprise for Jude. Either dog her pick, you know, is going to be lovely.
Oh, you're a little pocket rocket.
Sit down. We'll wait for her to get
just
some of her energy
bit, yeah.
out. She's tiring. I can sense it.
So Eva keeps thinking that she's actually going to calm down a lot quicker than Schnitzel.
I think Lily's quite a high energy level.
Yeah, Lily. Yeah. Look at she wants. Up here.
Good girl. Sit.
Wow, Johnny's actually.
Schnitzel's like here and then here. She's like always in the middle. Aren't you? You're like
tire eventually. Her legs a little. Surely you're getting tired.
She is only so young still, so she has so much energy.
Now you have a little break for a minute. Hey?
Straight in the. Oh, Lil. Oh, you want to play again? Here. Look, it's a little here. Go on.
She's still running, is she?
She hasn't stopped.
Full of beans.
More energy too than I thought she would have.
Yeah,
but
so she is quite energetic.
Yeah.
She does eventually settle down, though.
Yeah.
There's a lot more emotion involved than I first initially thought, to be honest.
It must be so hard for you guys after meeting both of them.
I know.
Will the head win or will the heart win?
Who knows?
Who knows? Not quite sure.
Cute, both cute. I can't. I know where you're thinking. I could tell you now what dog you would choose.
This is Sophie.
You're very sweet. She's excited to see you.
My name's Taylor.
I'm Emily.
So tell us about Sophie. What's she like?
Very calm and relaxed dog.
Yep.
Yeah, and she likes to lick. She won't bite, but she'll lick.
Yeah.
That's all she does.
Well, she's beautiful. So what would your ideal dog then be?
Something that I can hug. Something that I can play with.
Yeah.
I want just like, we would like a smaller dog, kind of like Sophie.
A dog that can cope with being suffocated by these two.
Yeah, we pretty much just suffocate Sophie and hugs and stuff.
Yes.
Are you guys open to a dog with any medical issues? Is age a factor? Is there anything that would sort of stop you guys?
Dentition? Do we care?
Nope.
I love those.
I love those. And I don't know. They're like the peace of my world. It's like without dogs, I would be crazy.
How exciting is that?
No, Sophie, you stay with us.
I do get jealous of Sophie because I'm like, why do I never get a go? Why is it always Zone? And I do get upset about it a lot.
I think it's so important for the dog to get along with Azri because you can see Sophie's so attached to Zoran. She's, the whole time, she was sitting on his lap.
Yeah, for sure.
We'll go through some options.
Tala was one I was thinking of. So she's a griddle mix. She's only a year old. She's not still like a little puppy. She's quite an active dog, pretty bouncy.
How she plays with other dogs.
Yeah, she's quite full on.
She's quite full on.
Yeah, she won't stop either, so. And is quite jumpy as well, so.
She's jumpy.
Yeah, I know that. But, yeah. And then I guess we've got the other one is the Shih Tzu who came in.
Martin,
Lorenzo, and Alfonso. So they came through, unfortunately, the owner passed away. Bit of a sad one there from there. Yeah, very sweet dogs, and Martin's a very sweet boy.
Yeah, he's been around elderly dogs already, with living with his mother, who's, what, 7?
Yeah.
Same age as little Sophie.
Hopefully, fingers crossed, both dogs are going well, and then have an adoption.
Okay, we've come up with an idea. So his name is Martin.
He is a smaller breed. He is a Shih Tzu Maltese mix.
Behaviourally, not the kind of dog that you could probably run straight up to and pick up and cuddle as much as you could with Sophie just yet.
Yep.
But then does warm up to you eventually. So I was having a cup of tea the other day and he came and he jumped into my lap.
So, well, it ticks your boxes. You wanted to rescue a dog in trouble.
What boxes has he ticked?
Being a rescue. I wanted a rescue. So I got a second chance of life and I wanted to give a dog a second chance of a happy life.
May I ask if you know about what happened?
I broke my elbow. I fell off monkey bars.
Yeah.
And in the middle of surgery, they worked out that I had a heart problem.
One of the doctors from the heart ward took me into a room and basically said that there was something wrong with our daughter's heart. It's a serious life condition and it's not one that has a long lifespan.
So I think Sophie helped Zaren get through that 9 months. It was really, really stressful for him. It was difficult. I just felt like I was in a zombie world. Just get up, go to work, come home, cook tea, go to bed, just day after day. And I just didn't want to think too much about it because it just broke my heart. So.
Yee, so excited!
We're on the road to Martinville.
Hi, Sam. This is Sophie.
Hello, Sophie. Hello.
The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a toy and just sit there.
The Mortimer Brown family are about to meet cute little character, Martin.
Well, hey, Martin. Hey, buddy. Hey, family. How you doing?
And if he plays his cards right, he may become dog number 2.
Is
signs when he first came in of nervousness, and then with encouragement, he's been getting a lot more confident, and he's enjoying his walks and plays in the yard.
I'm just too excited to know.
This waiting is
horrible, torturous.
Yes, it is. I found it really difficult when speaking to one of the doctors saying that other parents have let their child pass away. And we just said, no, we can't give up. We've got to give it every chance.
The only option at the time of keeping our daughter would be to have a heart transplant.
Gonna explode. Stay at the store till somebody walks in.
She was getting sicker and sicker.
Her organs were in shut down.
It wasn't living. It's holding your breath and not being able to let go. Head nurse walked in at 1 o'clock in the morning and she said to me, you have a heart? My first words were, are you sure? The nurse said to me, should we wake her up and tell her? And I'm like, yes. So at 1 o'clock in the morning, they rolled her into surgery. And I remember ringing you and I was saying, wakes aren't up, the heart process was happening. And
I felt like I'd won the lottery. That was just relief.
Sophie's coming across.
Come on.
Here he comes.
Oh, God. Give me.
Yes, it is. Good job.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Aww.
Come on, buddy. This is Martin.
What do you think, sir? Does he look handsome?
Martin. You want to try one? Can you try one? Yeah, go. Won't you?
He's just checking
out. Okay. I'm just going to... Martin, do you want to smell?
Hey,
no, you're too scared. Okay, I'm sorry.
So you can see he's really low body, that tail is tucked under, the ears are back.
I really don't think he's had any interaction with,
hey, Martin.
With many okay. Many people or children.
Yeah.
He's very like hypervigilant, looking around all the time.
The alert of what's going on around.
You can feel his apprehension. It's okay. I look after you.
No.
Good work.
Oh, he likes you.
Oh, look, perfect. He's still scared, but he really wants to be friends with them.
I'm going to leave you guys.
No, specifically warms up to Azri.
There you go, Martin. I think he got scared.
Just exploring.
Yep. He just needs to sense that we're in no danger.
Hey, buddy. Martin. Come on, you bear. No? You sit down here. Do you want to come on? Can you make it up? You gotta come on.
Oh, I really hope he jumps up next to her.
Okay, Martin.
Yay!
Oh,
awesome.
Oh, how cute. She's got this big smile on her face.
It was bittersweet because I still get emotional about it. About the other family that's lost someone. We're all celebrating that we've, our child's survived. And their family member hasn't.
Buddy, you scared me.
And we're really thankful. And they're heroes of our eyes. Sorry.
Sniff.
I think she was very brave, and I think it was an amazing thing she went through.
You're gonna go make a new friend, little one.
Nice pink lead.
Beautiful, matches your eyes, Sam.
Yes, thank you.
When you are introducing a second dog to a family, you've got to take it really slow. Obviously, we are the experts, so we know what we're looking for. So we do it very carefully and watch every move.
So
all goes really well, hopefully they go home together.
Who's that, Martin?
Sam, I'm the shelter manager. We'll go past each other like half a meter apart, just to see all their interactions, see there's a bit of...
Everyone's so intently watching.
So he's a bit more timid, she's better.
You just gotta keep everyone calm and let the dogs make their own choices.
Oh, Sophie, it's okay, it's okay.
Okay, so.
Come on, Soph.
Sophie.
Good girl.
Pardon.
Is he another drink? No, he's a bit more quiet. Come on, Soph.
Sophie.
Martin's future with the Mortimer Browns rests in the pampered paws of their beloved Sophie.
If you stay still, Josh, I'll just come to you.
Behind you.
Say hello. There we go, mate.
Good work, Martin.
Good boy, Martin.
Good boy.
Are you drooling?
Yeah, I've never seen a drool before. She does it when she's scared, nervous, or very excited.
Good boy.
But his tail, look, his legs, his tail, okay. Just needed a second. She could not care less that there was another dog in there with their family. He's just sort of slotted in.
You're okay, keep going.
There's none of this territorial protective behaviour over her family. She's actually gone to go find Martin now.
It's okay, Martin, you're okay. Okay. It's kind of cute. I've never seen a sponge like that fast. That's how I play with her sometimes.
Oh my god.
So what she's doing there, she's trying to engage Martin to play with her.
Maybe you can get Martin to play with her.
This is what we want.
Yeah. Getting another dog, it will just give her something to focus on.
It's actually not a cure, a transplant, because she'd probably have to have another one.
So we still live with the concept that could be heart rejection that can happen at any time. Mm. But I think this has given us the ability just to live life now and to celebrate everything that we have right now.
Come on, go here. Yeah, just go, Martin.
Yep.
He has loosened up so much.
Oh, he has. He's doing a little, like, staunch.
Oh, I think this is... such a good match.
I want to join them.
Let's play.
I want to join them.
Come on, you can't get me.
Oh my goodness, she's excited. That was so gorgeous, wasn't it?
This is what we wanted.
Yeah.
Someone to play with Sophie.
And it's just felt like our family's complete if this works out.
Guys, what we'll do, we'll take them for a walk, just see how they go together on a walk.
Ashley, would you like to walk Martin?
Yes.
Come on, Martin. You're okay. Come on, buddy.
You're okay. You just got to follow Sophie. Sophie's leading the way, and Zoran's leading Sophie.
Like, people don't really think how important life is because it's just life. But once your life is going to stop, you do notice, wow, this life is actually much more important than you think it is. Yeah.
What do you want to eat? So when I met Jimmy, I was actually pretty scared because he came out of that door, he was running. He was sprinting. I also felt nervous. If we would take him home, he would act the same.
Another concern I had with Jimmy was that he was going to get into all my rugs, he was going to pull my curtains down, he was going to eat my shoes. But could we say no to Jimmy in the end?
Timmy!
Come on, Timmy.
Of course not.
So we did decide to change Jimmy's name. It's now Sumo. And that's obviously because he's the biggest dog in the world.
He likes to think he's the biggest dog in the world.
Sumo is my boy, my long lost boy.
Hey, Sumo here.
You're a cheeky boy. It is nice having a masculine presence in the house. The only thing is he's not watching the footy with me yet.
I've overcome my fear of being scared of him.
Rawr. Rawr.
I thought of was, you were such a scruffy dog.
Please,
it was all up to Sophie. She decided, yes.
Martin!
Come here, boy. Come here! Come here!
Pick him up. There we go.
Hey, boy. No, hey, hi.
Since we've had Martin, life has changed for the better. The kids are no longer just fighting over Sophie. They both have a dog each. When you say, come on, kids, it's bedtime, it's not that deep breath of, oh, here we go again.
He's sort of brought a lot more joy to all of us. He's filled in that missing link. So we've got the chickens running around, we've got the dogs running around, got the kids running around, and us running around after all that. Just, he's meant to be here.
It's very nice to give Martin a second chance because I got a second chance, and now he's got a second chance for the best poem ever.
Second time lucky for schnitzel.
Oh my god. I really just want to find out its personality.
Can Frosty's winning smile lead to love?
Frosty doesn't like
me. And the stakes are high for long-term Raj.
I've fought for him for so long.
When he meets a former army doctor.
I'm a broken person. That's why I need a doc.
Can these troubled souls connect?
Raj!